सेकेंड 1/2 × 1/2, थर्ड 1/2 × 1/2 × 1/2, एंड फोर्थ 1/2 × 1/2 × 1/2 × 1/2. नाउ वी हैव टू कंप्लीट 2 × 2 = 4, 2 × 8 = 16, सो 1/16. सो प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ फोर सन टू ए कपल इज व्हाट? 1/16. ओके, नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज एक्स्ट्रा न्यूक्लियर क्रोमोजोम्स अकर इन Recently we have seen, now here options are there, peroxisome and ribosome. Next option is there, mitochondria and chloroplast. Next option is there, mitochondria and ribosome. Next option is there, chloroplast and lysosome. We already know extra nuclear gene or chromosome that occur in where? Mitochondria and chloroplast, and some kappa particles, sigma particles are also having this. Okay, so these are the having what? Some questions. Now come on, next question. Ratio of complementary gene okay what I told ratio of complementary gene is first is 9:3:3:1, next is 12:3:1, next is 9:7, and next is 9:3:4. Okay, so this is the options that having, and we know that already discussed complementary gene, that we remember this C and a central nervous system. So C for complementary, N for 9, and S for 7. Okay, so what will the answer here? Complementary gene ratio is 9:7. Okay. Now, next question is, when dominant and recessive alleles express itself together. So, when the dominant and recessive alleles expresses itself together, it is called, what it is telling? First, it is, option is codominance. Next option is there, dominance. Next option is there, pseudo-dominance. And next option is there, none. So we know that if both the alleles expresses together, so that is known as what? Codominance. Now, next we have to come on. One question is there. There are three genes, A, B, and C. So come on that. There are three genes, A, B, and See, the percentage of crossing over, the percentage of crossing over between A and B, between A and B is 20%. They are telling what? 20%. B and C is 28%. And A and C is 8%. Okay, A and C is 8%. What will be the sequence of genes on chromosome? So, what will be the sequence of genes on chromosome? Okay. Now, here options are there. First option is A, B, C. Second option is B, A, C. Third option is A, C, B. And fourth option is none. Now, we already know this type of questions we have to see first. What is the biggest one? B and C. So, B to C is 28. A to B, it is given 20%, and A to C, it is given 8%. So we have to mingle like that. This biggest one will be merge that one. So if we are coming on ABC, so A, B, C. So A to B, what is that? 20. And B to C, what is that? 28. So if we are mingling this one, so this one very much high. So this is not right. Come on BAC. So BAC, BAC, AB or BA having 20 and AC having 8. And if these two are combining, so this is coming what? 28. So BC having 28. So what was the right answer? This one is the right answer. What is the sequence? BAC is the right sequence of these three genes. Okay. Now come on next. Now, next question is, a plant of F1 generation has genotype. A plant of F1 generation having genotype. Now, genotype is AA, BB, capital C, capital C. Now, here questions are asking, on shelving the plant, what will be the phenotypic ratio in F2 generation? On shelving the plant, what will be the phenotypic ratio? In F2 generation. Now options are there. First is 9:3:3:1. Next is 3:1. Next is 1:1. And next is none of these. Now, if we are coming on this question, you can see this is the tricky question. Here what they are telling, genotype A, B, B, C, C. So here, this is asking what? Only one hybrid is there. So it is monohybrid case. And we know monohybrid phenotypic ratio. Phenotypic ratio is equal to 3:1. Okay, we know already. So this is the answer. 3:1. Now, Come on, one. Which of the following is example of sex-linked disease? Which of the following example belongs to sex-linked disease? Now, options are there. First is AIDS. Next is color blindness. Next is syphilis. And next is gonorrhea. We already discussed sex-linked diseases are color blindness, hemophilia are there. So here what will happen? Color blindness belongs to sex-linked disease. Okay. Now, next question is, two crosses between the same pair of genotype or phenotype. Two crosses made between same type of genotype or phenotype in which sources of gametes are reverse. In which sources of gametes are reverse and the result having same is called. What he had told that two crosses made between same type of pair of genotype or phenotype in which sources of gametes are reverse means one time male and another time that male is behaved as a female. So this type of phenomenon is called. So it is called what? Option A, test cross. Option B, reciprocal cross. Option C, out cross. And option D, none. So what will happen? If result same and gametes are reverse, so that is known as what? Reciprocal cross. What is that? Reciprocal cross. Understood? Now, next question is there. A self-fertilizing trihybrid. Come on that. Next question. Next question is that a self-fertilizing trihybrid plant forms. A self-hybrid trihybrid plant forms. A self-hybrid, or we can say self-fertilizing hybrid. Self-fertilizing trihybrid plant forms. Now, what are the things they are forming? So, first is there are 8 different gametes and 64 different zygotes. So, first is 8 different gametes and 64 different zygotes. Another is 4 different gametes and 16 different zygotes. Another is 16 different gametes and 32 different zygotes. And last one is 24 different gametes and 64 different zygotes. Okay, now we know that what they are giving, trihybrid plant. So this is what trihybrid means. Here n is equal to 3. Now they are asking gametes and zygotes, and we know that number of gametes is equal to 2 to the power n, and number of zygotes is equal to 4 to the power n. So 2 to the power n means 2 to the power 3, 2 to the 4, 2 to the 2 into 2 into 2, it will be 8, and 4 to the power 3 means 4 into 4 into 4, so it will be coming at 64. So how much will come? 8 different type of gametes. So this is the 8 different type of gametes, and zygotes, 64 different type of zygotes. What will the answer? Answer will be first. Okay. So this type of questions are coming in the principle of inheritance and variation. Some more questions we'll discuss tomorrow, and then we'll start next chapter, molecular basis of inheritance. Thank you.